Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to be doing more of a fun 50 facts about me. So not necessarily like a beauty video, but I do have this look posted on my channel. It is my Valentine's Day look that's really easy, simple, but still glam and fun to just wear on other occasions too, because Valentine's Day has passed. But let's go ahead and let me tell you a little bit about myself. Like, let's just share here. So I'm just gonna go ahead and kind of rapid fire through these and kind of give you little stories here and there if I feel like they need a little bit of context. So yeah, let's go ahead and get started. One, I am a lefty. Two, I have an older sister. She is 22 months older than me and her name is Bella and she lives in Seattle. I am from LA, but I just relocated to Vegas a few months ago. Not a few, I would say like half a year ago, maybe. I have had 10 hamsters growing up, all named after typically bakery items, and they all start with the letter C, so I can tell you a few. Chubby, Chubby the Second, Candy, Cream Puff, Cappuccino, Cupcake, Crumb Cake, Cheesecake, Churro, Cookie, and a guinea pig named Chocolat. I have two cats at home. One is a Turkish van named Moo. The other one lives with my aunt, but we adopted him initially for my grandpa, and I still consider him mine, and his name is Simba, and he's an orange tabby with a little nub tail. And we both adopted them from the same place, from a lady who kind of took in animals, and she kind of rehabilitated them, and they are some of the loves of my life. I have a dog here, and her name is Maple. Mabel, come here! It's a little bit of Ashley Cam right now. Hi, baby! Sit!
You're a good girl, aren't you? Hi!
She's like, can I get you? She talks a lot. I once owned a tortoise when I was really, really young at my grandparents' house, and it went missing, so my cousins and I drew signs of the tortoise and posted all over our neighborhood as kind of like missing. And yeah, and then when we finally found him, we put a little string on his neck so he wouldn't go anywhere. That makes sense, but of course he still left. Like, we didn't really attach the string to anything, so whatever. I don't know how to open the front door at my house in LA, like my parents' house. I never have known, and I never will know. I live in Las Vegas, you already know that. I am a denim-aholic. Like, if there's one item that I splurge on, well, obviously besides makeup, it is denim. Like, I love good quality, designer, high-end denim, just because I wear jeans every single day, or almost every single day, and denim's really important. Like, I just feel like it's a lifestyle, and once you have a really good pair of jeans, you feel good about the rest of your day. I don't like eggs. I mean, I'm very finicky, I should say. Like, I don't like boiled eggs, I don't like poached eggs, I don't like fried eggs. Like, I only like scrambled eggs if I make them myself, or if they're in a breakfast burrito or an omelet. Like, I'm just very picky. I can't do eggnog, don't like mayonnaise, I can't do deviled eggs, like none of that. Like, no thank you. Without my contacts, I have the vision of a legally blind person, and I have astigmatism. Bad vision is just kind of like hereditary in my family, I guess. I'm the first generation American on my mom's side and second on my dad's side. My dad was born in Salinas, California. His parents are from China. My mom is from Hong Kong, so I am first gen on her side. I grew up swimming. Swimming has been a huge part of my life. I swam competitively for many years. I swam at a club team, swam on my high school. I was captain of my swim team and my water polo team. I was told when I was on my high school swim team that I had beefy arms, and I've been insecure about them ever since. I played piano competitively for over a decade, and I still like to play to this day. I don't have a piano here in Vegas, but next fact, I do have a guitar that I asked my parents for my 16th birthday, and it's still one of my favorite birthday presents I've ever received. I taught myself, and I do have to have that here. And every once in a while, I just like to pick it up and I like to play songs. Just covers of songs that I've either heard on the radio or that I've found online, or things that, you know, I've just kind of been stuck in my head. I'll like to play it, so yeah. My car is a Nissan Versa hatchback and it is covered in stickers and it's white. I really love white cars, but yeah. I collect shot glasses everywhere I travel. When my friends travel, I ask them to bring me shot glasses because it just makes the world go round. I am obsessed with Bath & Body Works candles, if you didn't know that by now, but You should. I consider myself to be a pragmatist and a realist. I used to consider myself to be an optimist, but I have kind of learned through life lessons and just growing up in reality that it pays more to just kind of be practical about things and to be real about things as opposed to having really high standards or false expectations for things. Not to say that being an optimist is bad, but for me, what I have found that suited better just for me living my life is to just be a pragmatist and just be real about things. My Myers-Briggs is ENFJ, which is extroverted, I'm intuitive, I'm more prone to feeling and judging. And apparently that's a pretty rare type. I think only 4% of the people in the world are diagnosed with being an ENFJ, and they're known as we are known as the protagonist. I have this huge keloid on my arm from when I went snorkeling in Hawaii last March. Oh my god, that was like almost a year ago. I went with my friend Sally and we had the best time, but I was snorkeling in Hanama Bay. I don't know if any of you guys have been there, but essentially what happened was I wanted to go to the little cove, the coral reefs, and see the fishes because that's where all the fish congregate. So I'm a pretty strong swimmer. I mean, as I said, I used to swim for many, many years. And that wasn't the problem. The problem was when I went to go swim further and further into the coral reefs, they became progressively more shallow. So I was essentially just kind of like sitting on top of the reef at some point. And when I tried to turn around, I would have to go back into the ocean and face the current. So the current was pushing into me and pushing me into the coral reef. So I have a lot of scratches and scars all over my body from it, but this is definitely the most pronounced one. It's a raised keloid, and yeah, that's the story behind this scar that you may see in my videos. If I could only watch one video for the rest of my life, it would be Friends. I was actually watching it recently on Netflix on repeat. I'll go through these binges where I just turn on Friends and nothing else, and it just makes my heart so happy. Like, it's just one of those shows that is so feel good. It was truly like a show that paved the way for sitcoms today and just shows in general. And it was just a miracle and by far, in my opinion, the greatest thing to happen to television, at least comedy television. A life lesson that I've learned is that if it's meant to be, it'll be. And it's hard to explain that concept because it varies in so many different ways for so many different situations. But just know that if you're unsure about something or the trajectory of a decision that you might make or what could be happening in the future, just know that if it's meant to be, it'll be. Like that song. If it's meant to be, it'll be, it'll be, baby, if it's meant to be. Love that song. I always end up creating nicknames for my pets and the people closest to me in my life, and I can't help but do so. Like my best friend Connie, I've known for 18 years. Yes, 18 years. I'm 22. I met her when I was 4. I call her Connis, and I call our other friend Brandis, and they call me Ashless. It's just kind of a thing. I call Simba and, oh, I introduced her as Moo, huh? Because that's her nickname. But I call Simba, my cat, Mump, because he's orange like a pumpkin that changed to Mumpkin with an M and changed to, it's a long story. And yeah, they all have different names to me. If you're close to me, your nickname is coming. I am always wearing a necklace, specifically this one, and a watch, which I'm actually not wearing today because mine just ran out of battery and I actually ordered another one. So yeah, that's a little bit awkward because it's not here, but yeah. Usually always wearing those two things. Those are my go-to accessories. And then earrings are always just kind of extra for me. They're like when I'm in the mood. But yeah, those are the two things that I feel naked without. Sushi is my favorite food. Anything sushi. Sashimi, rolls, anything. Just give it to me. Raw fish, I love it. Poke. Ugh. Fresh air is very important to me. I work in an office for 10 hours a day, or 9.5 hours a day, but on my 30-minute lunch break, I always make it a point to go outside and to just chill there and eat because, ugh, I just love that fresh air and the view is so beautiful. And out here in Nevada too, the air is so much cleaner, albeit drier than LA. And I just love that everywhere I look, there are mountains and I just feel a lot more at peace here. I love the color teal and turquoise. I have teal and turquoise, everything this chair I'm sitting on, that pillow over there, my hydro flask, anything bright teal or turquoise, I love. My favorite Twitter accounts are probably Chrissy Teigen's and Sheebs, the Shiba account, which is, I think, at Shiba Central, because I love Shiba Inus, and they're just so cute. Adopting Maple, my dog, who you saw here, from the shelter at the Nevada SPCA was the best decision that I've made since moving to Nevada. She is just everything and more, and I just love her so much. And I never knew how much a dog could truly love you, but it is so true what they say, that a dog's love is truly unparalleled. Like, I still love my cats the same, but like, it's a different kind of love, and the love that they give to you as well. And it's just, I don't think I could live without her here, honestly. I have different phases that I go through and say repeatedly for a period of time before I move on to something else, and I have these like different voices and different noises that I just spontaneously make out of nowhere. It's really weird, but like, it's a thing, guys. It's a thing. I can't live without brow gel, mascara, concealer, and a tinted lip balm. And I would say highlighter, but like, come on, like if I were to go to the no, you know what, I would need highlighter too if I went to a desert island, so that it can reflect off the sun and someone could come rescue me. I've known my best friend Connie for 18 years. As I said, we met when we were 4, and she's just my rock. I love her. This is a fun fact. James Valentine of Maroon 5 asked me out one time on a date when I met him randomly at a bar in LA. It was the weirdest / funniest thing that's happened to me. In case you don't know who James Valentine is, he's a guitarist from Maroon 5, and if you don't know who Maroon 5 is, you're living under a rock. I love baths, but I can't stay in them for more than 15 to 20 minutes. I am trying though, I just ordered like a bath tray, so hopefully that will enable me to just stay in there and maybe read a book or chill on my iPad or just feel more inclined to just stay in there longer. Some of my favorite adventures that I've had in my life include climbing a waterfall in Jamaica, that was scary as hell, cliff jumping into the American River when I went river rafting, which is kind of a river up in Northern California in Sacramento, and going snowmobiling in Mammoth, I believe. I was on my mom's back, this was back years ago, and I remember she went off course, because that's the kind of thing that she does, but it was so much fun and it was safe, but yeah, it was really, really fun. I was born on Thanksgiving Day, which was November 23rd that year, and actually it was Thanksgiving last year as well, and because of that, I am a cusp or Sagittarius. Like, I am the first or second day of Sagittarius, and that's why I'm very indecisive. I am very OCD. I broke my thumb while playing water polo in college my senior year when I was captain, and I couldn't play inter-city championship game, and that was one of the things that still to this day makes me really sad. I have a hole on the top of my right ear. I'm not sure if you can see it. I've never tried putting anything in there, but I know that my mom has it too, so I'm not sure if it's like a birthmark, but let me know if you have that too. One of my nervous habits is not biting my nails. It's kind of stroking like my chin fat. Does anybody else do that? Like, is that really weird? Because I just sit there and I just find myself going like this. Or I'll peel my lips, as disgusting as that sounds, but yeah, those are my nervous habits. In general, I do love musicals and country music. My favorite musical is Phantom of the Opera, and I love a lot of country music. Like, don't at me. It's great, okay? I love stories. I love like narrative music, and that's what country music is, so I like it. I like black coffee and unsweetened tea, but if you give me a really good flavored latte, I will drink it up. Or if you give me like really good like boba milk tea or like a green tea latte, ugh, I just love it. I grew up immersed in the entertainment industry, and you might be thinking, so cliche, so LA of you, but no, my mom works in the industry, so I've been pretty lucky to have gotten to know and meet a lot of people in the industry. Some I really love, some I don't love so much, some I'm close with, some I just met once. But yeah, it's been a really interesting kind of ride. I was once too traumatized in my freshman year of college to go to a class because I watched the season finale of Person of Interest, or maybe it wasn't the season finale, but I watched an episode of the show called Person of Interest where one of my favorite characters of all time dies, and I actually emailed my college professor and I was super honest. I told her, I was like, I can't come into class today because my favorite character on my show just died. And fun fact, when I met with her for a one-on-one conference, she was like, do you mind telling me what that show was? And I told her, oh, it was Person of Interest. And she was like, oh my god, me too, I almost didn't want to come into lecture. And I was like, You are my spirit animal and I love you. Last but not least, I studied broadcast journalism and entrepreneurship at USC. I just graduated last year. And I knew that I didn't really want to be like a reporter for a news station, and I'm not. I actually work in news right now at a tech company, but in a very different way. But I actually think this is kind of like a fun way of combining like both my broadcast degrees and my entrepreneurship degree, just kind of starting out here on YouTube and just riding the wave and seeing where it takes me. If it goes somewhere, great. If it doesn't, great. If it's meant to be, it'll be, right? So yeah. All right, guys, so those were all of my 50 facts about me. I hope you enjoyed getting to know me a little bit more with some of these random yet fun facts about me and my life and who I am. I would love to know a little bit more about you, so let me know anything that you think is interesting or fun or quirky or idiosyncratic about you, and I would love to know and check it out. So yeah, this is a two-way street, guys. Like, I know I say like comment down below, but like I genuinely like I want to know like who's out there watching my videos besides my friends. Shout out to you guys, I love you. But yeah, that wraps up this video. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.